All right, let's see how well you did on these RACE-Cs. The question was, do people really get cold feet? And you had to support your answer with evidence from the Mythbusters episode Cold Feet. This first one is a level 4 above and beyond. Yes, I do believe that it is possible for someone to have cold feet when they try something scary. According to the Mythbusters episode, right there, my according to, that is what I would consider a citation. So the person has restated, they've answered, and they have cited. And then they go in to tell me what their piece of evidence is. Right here, it starts with Grant. Grant had to do something with spiders. He was afraid of the spiders, and his feet temperature dropped 15 degrees Fahrenheit. That all is one piece of evidence where the person is telling me what happened, and it's telling me the evidence, which is all about the cold feet, the temperature drop. In Carrie's experiment, this is my second piece of evidence, so I've cited it, telling where it came from. In Carrie's experiment, she was also afraid of a bug. The temperature of her feet also drops nearly 15 degrees Fahrenheit. Right here, this is important. It says the temperature changes in feet show that the temperature of feet is affected by scary situations. That is what I would consider explaining your evidence. The person didn't just list the evidence, they actually explained it and connected it to how it has to deal with cold feet. In conclusion, I like how this person said, in conclusion, people really do get cold feet. That would be a level 4 above and beyond, and on the ECA, that would receive extra credit. Level 3, complete and correct. This would be considered full credit on the ECA, but we obviously are striving to be above and beyond. Yes, I do believe that it is possible for someone to have cold feet when they try something scary. Here's my citation, according to the Mythbusters episode Cold Feet. Grant had to do something with spiders. There's my evidence. His feet temperature dropped 15 degrees Fahrenheit. In Carrie's experiment, the temperature of her feet also dropped nearly 15 degrees Fahrenheit. In conclusion, people really do get cold feet. Now here, they do have two pieces of evidence, and again, as I've told you, in the ECA, you want to look for three, but if there are not three pieces of evidence, it is okay. It is okay to cite two, because in this Mythbusters episode, they did only give two solid pieces of evidence. But the reason this got a level 3 is actually because they did not explain their evidence. They just said, according to the Mythbusters, something with spiders, temperature dropped. Cool. And in the experiment, temperature dropped. What does that have to deal with cold feet? I liked how in the level 4, this person up here said, the temperature changes in feet showed that the temperature of feet is affected by scary situations. This person did not do that. Level 2, missing something. It's going to be pretty obvious what this person is missing. Yes, I do believe it's possible for someone to have cold feet when they try something scary. According to the Mythbusters episode Cold Feet, Grant had to do something with spiders. He was afraid of the spiders, and his feet temperature dropped 15 degrees. In conclusion, people really do get cold feet. It's obvious this person only has one piece of evidence, and the Mythbusters episode presented two. So this would be missing something, and this would not receive full credit on the ECA. Finally, a level 1 would be considered incorrect. This would be considered a D or an F on the ECA as far as for that RACE-C, because obviously, yes, the evidence shows that our feet do get cold when we're in scary situations. So the answer is yes, that would be the correct answer. This person answered no, that is incorrect. So even if they did have good evidence, which by the way, they don't, they would not receive full credit because they answered incorrectly. All right, be sure that you give the person that you are grading either a level 4, a level 3, a level 2, or a level 1, and then we will go over what you can do to fix your answers.